I think at this particular moment in American history, that we are losing a sense of community in a larger sense that has almost nothing to do with the size of the community that you live in. There's a lot of things at play: the internet, the political culture, the decline of certain institutions, whether that's the church or civic organizations. All of that are having a harmonic convergence, I think, right at this moment, that makes it harder for us to think of ourselves of what do we have in common, what do we share, versus let me illuminate for you all the things that I don't like about you.
We need to be reminded of our stories, because we're in perhaps the greatest existential threat we've ever had since the Great Depression and the Civil War. So we are going to be the authors of our own demise. In fact, there's an amazing quote by Abraham Lincoln. He said, "When shall we expect the approach of danger? Shall some transatlantic giant step the earth and crush us at a blow?" Then he answered his own question, "Never. All the armies of Europe, Asia, and Africa could not by force take a drink from the Ohio River or make a trail in the Blue Ridge in the trial of 1,000 years. If destruction be our lot, we must ourselves be its author and finisher. As a nation of free men, we will live through all time or die by suicide." I mean, it's amazing. And he would go on, of course, to preside over the closest we've come to national suicide, the Civil War. But it's kind of, in some ways, optimistic, you know, that these two oceans are going to protect us, so we don't really have some foreign threats. What we have is our own threat. And if you don't get that us individually, we're our own worst enemies, and collectively we are, then you miss the kind of opportunities that we need to sort of realize today and seize the bull by the horn and say, look, you know what? I want my country back. I don't want the tribalism. I like the idea that we're civilized. I like the idea that that with all these immigrant groups, we're a stronger alloy. You know, individual metals, yep, strong, but nothing's like an alloy in putting stuff together and having that tensile strength that you want to have. And that's the beauty of us.